practicing our hello to this podcast thing today. It's just me. I think Alex is going to be joining soon. Ryan definitely ain't joining. He ain't even online, to be honest with you. We don't have any more people at the moment. We are getting more people. I do know some more people, so yeah. So what we're going to be talking about, international break. What do we want to do first on latest EFL news? We'll just get that out of the way really fast and then get to international break stuff. So Sunderland are getting their new safe standing, a new PA system, new floodlights, a new playing service, and 5G enabled stadiums. So that's really good for Sunderland, as they do need that. Stadium's getting a bit old. Stadium of Light is. So yeah. Steve Evans has been charged for failing to comply with the terms of his touchline suspension. So he has until the 21st of March, so until tomorrow, to respond. Right, we'll just get that out of the way. I don't want to say anymore. Let's just talk about the international break. So what are we going to talk about, you're wondering? We're going to rate the new kits. We're going to talk about all these international friendlies, even San Marino's tonight. Maybe some other stuff, maybe our predictions and stuff like that. So let's get started, eh? So we're going to be reviewing some of the kits. These will pop up on your screen if you don't know what they are. I don't know. There is thingy, whatever. So we got the New England kit. I like it. I really like it. I like the home one. The away one ain't so good. Don't know how what they all think, but that's my opinions. The home one, I personally think that's like solid seven. No, not a seven. Solid eight. It's so classic and it's really good. The away one, 5. I don't like the colour. I don't like the rainbow things on the sides at all. So that will be very nice. Coming up on your screen now will be the new Netherlands home and away kit. Oh, this is a personally, for me, must have. What a kit this is. I love both of them. The home one, it's just fresh, it is. Just plain, I like the pattern on it. Personally give it a 8, just like the England one. The away kit, it's even better, I'll give it a 9. It's nice and I like the pattern again. I like the colours with it. Curious. Xavi Simons in it looks good as well. It's very nice. I really do like it, if I'm honest. I might see if I can cop it. So now we're gonna go to the France kit. I'm gonna give this a 0. What is that? The badge looks massive on that. Looks massive, that does. I really don't like it at all. It's just, I think the England one's way better than that. I don't like any of them. Their away kit ain't even better at all. It's just, the badge ruins it. It's why have they made it so big, their new badge? It's so massive. It's crazy. Crazy. Let's have a look if we can find some other ones. So we got, wait, is that, oh my god, someone's messaging me. Personally, this new Brazil kit is very weird. very weird, and I'm giving that a 3. That is very, very weird. The home one is weird, the away one is weird. Why have they put the badge in the middle, the Nike logo there, and the pattern like that? It's ugly. It's so ugly, that is. I mean, it's just crazy how ugly that is. So terrible that is. Don't like that. That's all the kits were going to be rain because I obviously don't have a lot of time. We did record this yesterday, but it didn't go to plan, so I've had to record it again on my own. Don't know why Ryan ain't joining, but you know. So we're gonna have a look at some of these international friendlies coming up. So just want to say yesterday Notts County beat Bradford 3-0. That's pretty good, but yeah. Let's have a look. So tonight, everyone must watch this. You know who you're supporting, surely. You got San Marino versus St. Kitts and Nevis. Come on, San Marino. If San Marino, this is their chance to get their first win. Nani, the striker, he's been on brilliant form for his club at the moment, and I personally think he's going to score. I think San Marino are going to win this 2-1. They have a massive chance to get their first win in over 20 years, and I personally think they're going to do it. The next one we have today, El Salvador versus Bonaire. El Salvador is going to win this one, I think. Bonaire ain't good enough. El Salvador is brilliant. El Salvador played versus Inter Miami. Messi played versus them. And Suarez. So I think El Salvador will win that 3-0. Easy peasy. So tomorrow you got the World Cup, is it? Some World Cup qualifications. You got the Euro semi-final, the Nations League. You got the relegation final of the Nations League, and then loads and loads of friendlies. So we're not going to do the World Cup qualification just yet. The only interesting one there I can see is probably like Nepal versus Bahrain or Australia versus Lebanon, if I'm honest, but it's not very interesting. So, for the Nations League semi-finals, we have Poland versus Estonia. Easy 2-0 for Poland, personally. They're just playing better. Wales versus Finland. I think this will be 2-1 to Wales. Wales have just changed their thing around, and I think they're going to start playing well in all of these. We got Nations League semi-finals, and I think this is for B. Bosnia versus Ukraine. Ukraine easy 4-0. Israel versus Iceland. Iceland 2-0. Just pretty good. Georgia versus Luxembourg. Luxembourg 1-0. That would be an interesting game. Greece versus Kazakhstan. Now, this is an interesting prediction, but I think Kazakhstan will win this 5-3. Just because of the form they've been in recently. We won't talk about how they conceded to San Marino. That was a wins, but the form they've been in recently is pretty decent. Same as Greece, though. Drawing to France. Winning versus Ireland, but I personally think Kazakhstan will win that. And now the League C relegation final. Wait, is it the... Oh no, I was wrong. Those are the ones I've just said are the Euro qualification semi-finals. So we'll see who's in Fingy's group, England's group. That's pretty nice. So, the League C relegation final, Gibraltar versus Lithuania. Lithuania 2-0. Gibraltar just ain't good enough. Let's have a look at all the friendlies. Cyprus versus Latvia. Latvia 3-0. Russia versus Serbia. Serbia 1-0. Mitrovic, probably, or something like that. Suriname versus Martinique. 1-0. No idea who they are. Belarus versus Montenegro. No. Malta versus... There's Alex. Malta versus Slovenia. Personally think 1-0. Malta can get their form back. Cap Verde versus Guyana. No idea. Portugal versus Sweden. I think it would be 2-1 Portugal. Italy versus Venezuela. Italy 5-1. South Africa versus Andorra. 1-0. So that's all for tomorrow. So that's the 21st of March tomorrow. Now time for the 22nd. I'll only be reading the interesting ones out. I'm not going to go through all of these. So, Nigeria versus Ghana. Personally, 2-1 Nigeria. It's pretty interesting, that is. Are Ivory Coast playing soon? No idea. Here we go. Norway versus Czech Republic. Or Czechia. As they call them now. Personally think 3-2 Norway, just because of Ireland. Hungary versus Turkey. 4-1 Hungary. Form in the Nations League has been decent, and they haven't lost in 12 matches. Hungary haven't, so yeah. Netherlands versus Scotland. This will be pretty interesting, because Scotland have kind of came back from their form, but the Netherlands will win that 2-0, I think. Spain versus Colombia, Spain 6-1, personally. We're going to do Saturday, and then that's all our friendlies done. England versus Brazil, first, we'll say. It will be, I personally think, 2-1 England. But before we carry on with Saturday, so 23rd of March, happy non-league day to anyone that is a non-league supporter. If you go into a game on Saturday, make sure to DM us or tag us or anything. And make sure you send us some pictures, because we like non-league day, except I can't go this season, sadly. There's not that many games on, I think. Is Sutton playing? No, they're not. They're not playing. They're not playing on Saturday. Yeah, they're not playing. Versus who? Oh yeah, versus Accrington at home. So clearly Alex will be there, if anyone's an Accrington fan. Don't think anyone will be there, but there's not that really interesting ties on league day, to be honest. Kingsland versus Tamworth is the only good one I can point out, but that's from my Football Manager experience. So those are probably the... Why are San Marino playing the same team they're playing tonight again? By the way, just want to point out, today, I will punch... Today, England under 17s played Northern Ireland. They beat them 5-1. And guess who scored a brace on his debut? Bailey De Pepper. My man. What a player. He's actually... I've no idea how he's done that. But that's crazy. It's crazy. Oh, decent. So, how long have we been recording for? 50 minutes. That's pretty decent, if I'm honest with you. I know I'm missing something that I need to say, but I don't know what to say. No idea what to say, if on my list. Oh, why has Alex started a live stream? What is it? Let me commentate you through what he's doing. I don't know who that is, mate. I don't know who that is. Honestly. Manuel Neuer has got a bit of an injury. Poor him. Stop doing streams, for Jesus Christ's sake. Why are you watching curling? My God. Right, so Alex is watching curling now. I don't know what I'm about. I don't know what I'm doing. She would get it. Oh my God. Before Alex starts getting a bit weird, we're going to head off. We're going to get more people for the podcast, more active people. This is a short one, just signing out. G is Ollie. And Alex. Bye. See ya.